Okay, as you can see, we have a rational function right here. Of course, to integrate this, let's try to use partial fraction. And of course, we have to make sure that the degree on the top is lower than the degree on the bottom. It is, so we can go ahead and proceed. First, this denominator, we have to factor that. And to do so, we have four terms. So just like the good algebra days, we'll do this by grouping. So I'll look at these two and these two, and we can factor out x squared first, and then we get x minus 3. And then from here, we can pull out the 4, so we have x minus 3, like this. And then, of course, this and that are common factor. We can take that out as well. So we have x minus 3. And then we can just have x squared plus 4, like this. All right, so that's pretty much it for the factoring. And now, let me do the partial fraction on the side for you guys. And yes, x squared plus 4, we cannot factor it anymore. You have to deal with this right here. Now, let's talk about the setup. You have two different factors. This right here is linear. This right here is an irreducible quadratic. So the setup is going to be, let's write this down first, x minus 3. And because this is linear, on the top, it has to be 1 degree lower, which is just a constant, which is put on a. And then for this one, x squared plus 4. Well, as you can see, this is quadratic. In this situation, on the top, it has to be a linear. Namely, bx plus c. It has to be 1 degree less than the bottom, like this. And for this one, we can do cover up to take care of one letter only, namely a. Because I can go here and cover up x minus 3, and then I can make x minus 3 being 0 by plugging 3 into x. So I'll write this down right here for you guys. A is equal to when you plug in 3, into the rest of the x right there. So we end up 3 times 3 squared, and then minus 3 times 3, and then plus 8 all over. This is out already, putting 3 in here. So we get 3 squared plus 4, like this. All right, now let's see if we can do this or not in our head. Let's see, this is 9 times that is 27. 27 minus 9 is 18, plus 8 is 26. Over, this right here is 9 plus 3 is 13. So, you know, hey, this is just nice number 2. So that's good. You have 2 right here. And now, unfortunately, we cannot solve for b or c by using the cover up. You cannot make x squared plus 4 equal to 0 with 0 numbers. And also, you know, just don't deal with the cover up. So to figure out b and c, I'll just show you guys the traditional way to do it. We will come up with a system of equations, right? So what we'll do is, I'll look at this and then multiply everybody by x minus 3 times x squared plus 4. And let's see how this goes. And if you really want, you can plug in the x equal to 0, x equal to 1, because you haven't used them yet. You can put into all the x and then generate equations. You can do that, right? But I think I'll just show you guys this way. So when you do that, this times that, you just have this part left, which is 3x squared minus 3x plus 8. And you do this times that. Don't forget, a is 2 already. So you have 2. This times that, the x minus 3 cancel each other out. So you have just 2 times this, which is not that bad at all. And then this times that, of course, this and that cancel. You have this right here, which you don't know at the moment. I'll just write down b plus c in a parentheses right here. And you have to multiply by x minus 3. So you have to come up with system of equations if you don't want to plug in x values. Well, I think this right here is slightly easier because you have two unknowns. This right here will take care of that pretty easy. Just do the algebra. This is just algebra, okay? Anyway, here we go. On the left-hand side, we have a quadratic. On the right-hand side, we don't know what it is. We have to clean things up. To do so, just multiply this out. This is 2x squared plus 8. And then right here, of course, you do this times this, which is bx squared. This times this is minus 3bx. And then this times this is plus cx, and then this times this is negative 3c. Here is the deal. You are going to collect like terms. As you can see, you have 2x squared plus bx squared. You can factor out the x squared and you end up with 2 plus b and put the x squared here. Next, collect the linear term, namely the negative 3bx plus cx. And I will just put it as plus parentheses with negative 3b inside and then plus c and then multiply by x on the outside. Lastly, this is the term that has no x, likewise this. So this is the constant terms. Together, you just say you can add 8 minus 3c like that. And then if you look at the left-hand side, you have this. It's equal to this. And here is the deal. You're just going to equate coefficients, and this is how we can do it. Well, the easier one is, look, on the left-hand side, we have 3 in front of the x squared. That means this right here should also end up to be 3, isn't it? Yes. So this is really nice. I can just put down, we must have 2 plus b equals 3. And from here, you can see that b is equal to 1. Very nice. And you can also say negative 3b plus c has to be negative 3. But you don't have to, because you can also use this if you like. In fact, they happen to be equivalent. If you're putting 1 in here, you get negative 3 plus c. That will be negative 3. You end up with the same answer, okay? But anyway, I'll just do this right here for you guys. This is equal to that, which from here, b minus 3c equals 8. This tells us that subtract 8 on both sides, you get negative 3c. C is equal to 0. This is very nice. And again, when you're putting 1 here, you get negative 3b, which is negative 3, c has to be 0. So just use 2 out of these 3 coefficients, that will do the work. Yeah? You can use the last one to double check, but you don't have to. Now we'll come back here and then do the integration. Here's the calculus step, right? Okay, first we have 2 over x minus 3. Let me just write it down right here for you guys. And then next, b right here is 1, so we know this right here is 1, and c is equal to 0, so you don't have this anymore. You just have x over x squared plus 4. So you can just put this down right here, x over x squared plus 4. And in fact, this is very nice. You can integrate this. Usually it's not the calculus that people hate, it's the algebra like this that people don't like. Yeah, you can kick calculus in its head, okay? Seriously. Integrating this, you get 2 natural log absolute value of x minus 3. Integrate this, how do you do it? Yes, you do u substitution. I'll just write this down right here for you guys on the side, okay? That u equal to x squared plus 4. And then you do all that stuff, okay? I'll leave that to you. You add 1 half, also natural log in this case, and you put the denominator here, x squared plus 4. This is always positive. You just need a parenthesis. This right here is it. Put plus c, and you are done. Okay? Again, work out the u substitution on your own. This right here is it. Hopefully, this helps. And let me know if you guys have any questions, and I'll see you guys soon. That's it.